So you've probably heard or seen this on TV before, but it's your notification of rights, your Miranda rights. And so I'm going to read them to you, but I want to sit here where you can see the paper, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to read 1 through 5 right here. And so I'll read them, and you kind of can look at it with me. I want to make sure you understand all these. You have the right to remain silent. You do not have to answer any questions or make any statement. Anything you say can be used against you in court. You have the right to talk to a lawyer before we ask you any questions. And you have the right to have a lawyer with you during questioning. If you cannot afford a lawyer and want one, the court will appoint one for you before you are asked any questions. It's hard to read it sideways. If you want to answer questions now without a lawyer being present, you may do so. You have the right to stop answering questions at any time. So you understand what those are saying? Basically, if you want an attorney, just tell me. If you don't like any of the questions I ask, just tell me to stop. If you get uncomfortable, we'll stop whenever you want. Kind of, you're in control. Does that sound good? Okay. So what I want you to do is I'm going to read this waiver to you right here, and you look at it as I read it to you, because I'll make sure you understand it. It says, I have read the statement of my rights shown above. I understand what my rights are. I'm willing to answer questions and make a statement. I do not want a lawyer present at this time. I understand and know what I am doing. No promises or threats have been made to me, and no pressure of any kind has been used against me. So if you agree with that statement that I just read to you, that you're looking at, if you'll sign right there for me.
I don't know how well I can do my signature.
Yeah, just whatever you can do the best. And then if you will read and answer 1 through 4.
So put like high school?
Yeah. Yeah, because you had said you had graduated?
Yep.
Okay. For your formal education, and are you presently on any drugs or medication? You answered no. Are you under the influence of alcohol? You answered no. And you do read and speak English, obviously, but yes.
Yeah.
Sound good? Okay.
Do you take any prescription medications?
Well, man, I'm just kind of got thrown into this, so I was hoping maybe you could kind of just go back at the beginning when all this started and kind of tell me what happened, because I need kind of the details so we know and understand what you went through and stuff.
Okay, so I'm at the very start.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, about like 2 months ago.
Okay.
Is when we first really started talking.
So when you say we, who are you talking about?
Me and my other brother is also.
Your brother?
Yeah, who's his husband?
And what's his name?
Robert.
Okay. And how old is he?
18.
Okay. Alright, go ahead. Sorry.
A couple months ago, I think we got to the start of the year, we started talking about voodoo and rampage and stuff like that.
Okay.
And I didn't take it seriously at first, but then he started buying like body armor and stuff.
Where did he buy body armor from?
eBay and Amazon.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, legal.
Does he have a job?
He did, at Mike Tech, he quit at the start of the year. Basically, it just kept escalating, it kept getting ruined, and he asked if I went to the meeting, and I said yes, so he got me my own set.
Okay.
And then, about a month, about like June 30th, is when he came to me and said he found out that he can legally buy guns without permit in Oklahoma, and he could.
Okay.
And that's when he started planning. And,
Now you said he bought body armor, but you kind of said like a bunch of stuff that he bought. What else did he buy besides body armor?
Besides body armor, knives, and he was in the middle of buying guns and ammunition.
I see. Okay. Where did he buy the knives from?
eBay too.
Okay. Can you tell me like how many knives or what they look like or anything like that?
I think he had about 3 normal knives and then one small can of X.
Okay. And then the guns. Where did he start buying guns from?
He bought them online. I think the website's like Bud's Gun Shop, and he bought two Glock 41s. And And a shotgun, I forget, it's like a moss root, I think. Oh. But the rock stuff looks like old buds kind of shop, I think.
Okay.
And we bought the moss root off of the official website, and they kind of shipped to, like, Yogi Narrow Gun Club. So they were actually a guy now waiting for him.
So they were going, they were shipped to...
To a gun shop.
Here in Broken Arrow?
Yep.
Okay.
And
where is that gun shop, do you know?
He said 7 miles away, he was planning on biking up.
Okay.
It's like, and I think it's just to get mom. It's like the Okinawa gun shop.
Okay.
Or something. And then he bought, it goes like 250 shotgun rounds.
Okay.
On eBay. Not eBay, but on
some website. On some website.
And then I think he bought close to 1,000 rounds for the Glocks.
Wow, okay.
And
but he's still. To get out of oh, so he was supposed to have to pick those up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're supposed to pick them up today.
And where was he supposed to pick those?
By the ammunition. It was being shipped to the house. The guns with the Okinawa gun shop.
Okay. Do you know what his eBay user was?
No.
No. Okay. I just didn't know if you'd ever been on eBay and shopped or anything.
I used to on Target and not like, novelty stuff.
Right.
So he was buying weapons because you guys had talked about murdering.
Yeah, and he started planning it.
Okay.
And I went along with it because I see the way I thought I might do it. I thought I'd quit the news tonight, but I didn't.
Okay, that you didn't want to do it?
I don't want to do it. I didn't, just be clear, I didn't kill anyone.
Okay.
I stabbed someone.
Who did you stab?
My younger brother, Christopher.
Christopher? How old is Christopher?
9, I think.
What did you stab him with?
My knife.
What's your knife look like?
It's green, got like camouflage on it, so you might
Where your hand goes or where the blade is? It's camouflage?
Yeah, it's all camouflage.
Oh, the whole thing? Yeah. How big is it? Show me how big it is.
I think it's about this big.
Okay. So what was Christopher doing when you stabbed him?
He was laying on the bathroom floor. Robert was also stabbing him. Robert asked me to go over and help him. So I stabbed Christopher and then...
Where did you stab him?
Oh, stabbed him in the neck.
Really? Okay. You okay?
Yeah.
You okay? Let me know if you need a break or anything, okay?
I'm good.
So, was Christopher still alive when you stabbed him?
Yes.
What was he saying and doing?
He was just screaming.
Screaming. Was, did you say he was in the bathroom?
Yeah, he was next to the toilet, with that bathroom.
Who else was in the bathroom?
I think Victoria might have been in that boat.
Victoria?
Yeah, my 4-year-old sister.
4-year-old, okay. I want to talk about that more, but we got to try to kind of stay like chronologically, if you know what I mean. So let's go back real quick. We talked about the ammunition being delivered, making plans. Tell me more about making plans and what you guys talked about.
Making plans, we all plotted every night. And I started realizing we were actually going to do this thing on the second night. And so I started getting ready.
When was that? You used the second night, what do you mean?
July 1st.
Okay.
Because we started June 30th.
That's when you started making the plan?
Yeah, that's when we found out you could buy guns legally.
I see. Did you guys draw, make drawings or write things down? Or?
I think he had a journal. He was writing his ideas down. I think it's under his bed.
Under his bed?
Checked out.
Is it like a... Like a journal, like a notepad, or
yeah,
a book?
It's like a blank book.
Okay.
A black book. I think it's like a little case or something.
So you think he wrote stuff in there?
Yeah, I think he's planning it.
So then the second day you said that's when you realized that it might actually happen.
Yeah.
What made you realize that?
How serious he was. I mean, he was going through, he started planning on taking all of his money out of his, bank and throwing away stuff, throwing away all this stuff, so you know.
Why did he want to
do that? Kill people?
Yeah.
Well, mainly two reasons, I think. It's because he just, like, says he hates everyone. He thinks society is pointless, and so he wanted to kill people.
Now,
and also he wanted to, like, beat the kill, like, amount of other famous people like Columbine and James Egan Holmes.
Okay. Did you kind of feel that way too, like when you guys were talking earlier, like...
Yeah,
do you have a problem with society too, do you think?
No, I just...
Or you were just more like the number of people getting killed was kind of interesting and exciting?
Yeah.
Okay. So, because you mentioned a couple names of, are those like serial killers or something?
What, like Columbine?
Yeah.
Columbine and James Egan Holmes. James Egan Holmes is a guy that shot at the theater.
In Colorado?
Yeah, he killed 12 and...
Wow. How many were killed in Columbine?
Columbine, I don't know, like 15.
Okay.
I think.
So did you guys have a goal? Did you have a number?
I think he wanted to kill like 50.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a goal.
So as the planning goes, tell me what plans you started making and coming up with.
Well, originally, I think kind of stayed steady throughout the month, is so we wanted to kill everyone at the house first.
Okay.
And then wait for all the packages to show up over the weekend. They would take the economy to have our state with the guns and
Rampaging. Did you know where you were going to drive to?
Towards Washington.
Washington State or D.C.?
Washington State.
Why would you go to Washington State?
It's kind of the connection we planned on.
And you said Yukon. Do your parents have like a Yukon? Is that what it is?
Yeah, okay. It's a large Yukon XL.
Does Robert have a driver's license?
He has a limousine permit.
Okay. So he would be able to drive it. Can you drive if you had to?
No.
Well, you can play video games, surely you can drive a car.
It's
just not very well. I mean, you could get it from point A to B. You might hit some things on the way, but okay. So you had your plan. So what happened after? I mean, tell me some more.
Well, I think everything started falling in place.
Kleenex right there.
There we go. Oh. Or maybe it's from your finger, I don't know. Yeah.
But, back a week before is when I started feeling way useless stuff.
Okay.
That I need. And so did he.
Did you guys, like, give things away to friends or anything like that?
Threw it in the trash. I'm sure a lot of it's still in the barrels in the garage.
In the garage,
yeah.
What kind of stuff did you throw away?
Random stuff, toys, and stuff that was just piled up in my closet and I needed the room to put the body on.
Oh, I see.
Old shoes, clothes.
How long have you had the body armor?
Body armor? Robert's had his guy since it started ago, and we've been buying it. Well, he's been buying it.
Was it shipped to the house?
Yeah.
Do your parents know? I mean, did they know it?
They knew he had bulletproof vests. They always thought that was a little weird, but they didn't say anything about it.
Did he have anything else, like the gear that the guys wear, helmets or goggles or gloves?
Yeah, it's a soft glove vest, a heavy, I don't know, it's like a metal plated vest.
Okay.
Level three. He had a helmet, bulletproof helmet, a bulletproof DEA mask, and a lingos.
Wow.
Also like a knife proof
arm thing.
Yeah. Knife and balaclava.
Okay.
So yeah, it's nice.
And then the body armor that you had, what was it like?
It was almost identical.
Okay.
Just a couple of different models or something.
And where is your body armor now?
Well, my vests and my helmet, it was laying in the woods. The dog pulled it off of me.
Oh.
I was wearing it.
Oh, you were wearing it?
Yeah, I was wearing the sort of vest and the plate cover.
Okay.
So I took that. And the rest of my body armor is still in the closet.
Okay. So then kind of what happened is, I mean, you guys started getting all that stuff together and...
Yeah.
Throwing things away. And
yeah, and we do with all the packages and the holsters, arrow guards, all that stuff. It's going to get a few minutes on. And so we set a date.
So was the plan to use the knives at first on the family?
Because
the guns weren't going to be here till later on?
Yeah, and the guns would be too loud.
Oh, I see.
So going to use the knives on the family, which obviously did not go as planned.
Yeah.
Thank God.
Yeah.
I just saw the red swords right now. Like, we didn't put more people. I think.
Yeah. Did, so then you picked a date, you said?
Yeah, which was yesterday night. That was the date.
Did you pick a time and everything?
Yep, midnight when Mr. Bever was in bed.
So how did you guys know? He just came and got you, or you got him, or what did you
guys do? We were hanging out in the bed, waiting.
Okay, and so
how did you pick the date?
With Igor vaulting out the packages and stuff we have, because you know all the ammunition, he didn't want them to see that, so we killed him the day before the ammunition got out, the day after we leave.
Do you guys not like your mom and dad? I mean, most teenagers don't like their parents, so I can understand that.
Yeah, I mean, mom's okay, but dad was a little bit, you know.
Just a little bit too much. Yes. So, you guys wait in the room,
mm-hmm.
and was it right when midnight, and that's when things started?
Right at midnight, my sister, she came in, because she was going to go to bed, she came in to tell us.
How old is
13.
Okay.
She came in to tell us that mom wanted us to get the kitchen done before we went to bed and put the cats up. And basically, we did what we planned. I got to my desk, and I like had to look at something to just get to go up, but went up behind to grab to and slip with you.
Really? What did he use?
His large red knife.
Okay, a large red knife.
Yeah, it's like my
How
own.
Big is it?
It's like mine, but it's
about. Oh, I see.
So big. And then she fell to the ground screaming. Mom, Dad, you know, Mom came in first, and then.
Is your room upstairs or something? I don't know. I haven't been to your house, so I don't know.
Our room is downstairs. It's towards the back.
Okay. And so she fell down and started screaming.
Yeah, when I kept stabbing her, I kind of freaked out because, you know,
mm-hmm.
I wasn't planning on
this. Were you saying anything or, I mean?
I just stood there.
Okay.
And then Mom came in yelling, called the police. And then he ran over and stabbed her.
Then he stabbed her?
Yeah, he probably stabbed her, pushed her. You know, footed down the hallway and got up and ran.
Okay.
She ran out the door.
So she sat down at your desk and he slit her throat.
Well, she was standing at my desk and came up behind and slit her throat, and she fell down screaming.
And then he stabbed her some more? When he was stabbing her some more, where was he stabbing her?
Her neck.
Oh, her neck.
Her neck and stomach.
Okay.
And then my mom came in and she started yelling, called the police, get dad. And then he came over and started attacking her. He actually got up and ran out the front door.
Wow.
And once Mom was on the ground, he got up and started chasing after her.
And what were you doing? Did you come out in the hallway?
No, I was just standing in the room in the process. I don't know what I was doing.
So he stabbed your mom with the same knife?
Yep, same knife.
And where did he stab her?
I think in the neck too.
Okay.
He stabbed her in the neck, pushed her into the kitchen, and together. With you, she started screaming and ran into the family room at the same time he realized I left the house.
Okay.
I ran over and disabled the alarm.
Okay.
That's what I did. And then
where's the pad for your alarm?
It's now the front door.
It's what?
It's now the front door.
Near the front door?
Yeah. And so I went over and disabled the alarm so it wouldn't, you know.
But has she already gone outside?
She went outside and Robert went after her.
So where did she?
She was laying in the driveway and he took her back from, you know, the bench, you know, from the road, and started choking her.
On the bench out front?
Yeah, it was like a little bench, and he threw the bench on her and went back inside to go after the little kids.
Did he bring her in or did she stay out there?
She stayed out there until he asked me to bring her in. I ran out. I had to go her inside. That's why she's in the entryway.
You brought her back in. Yeah, she's still alive?
Yeah, she was still screaming. And then that's about the time Dad came down.
Okay.
Because his bedroom's upstairs. And he went back in the boys' area where Robert was. Boys' area, that's what they call it. And they started attacking there. They got a little bit of a fight. But then eventually Robert got him down and I think he killed him.
Did he cut his throat too? Where did that happen?
In our room.
In your room?
Yeah.
And where were you?
I was standing in the hallway.
Okay. So did you see him cut your dad's throat?
Yeah.
Did he stab him other places too?
I don't know. I think he just went for the throat.
And where was she? Was in the entryway?
Yeah, she was. I think she was in the entryway at that time. And then he went in and Daniel was in his room, which is, you know, down the hall. And I was like,
how
old
is Daniel?
I think he's 12.
Okay.
And I was like, let me in, whoa, and he let me in. He was sitting down on the phone with the police. I grabbed the phone, you know, which is my phone, got my phone. And then I went into the kitchen and I smashed the underground.
So which was your phone?
Yeah, it was my phone.
And you don't have a cell phone anymore.
And then I went back down. And he, and Daniel and Christopher locked himself in the bathroom. Daniel locked himself in Dad's office.
Okay.
And then I finally got both of them to open the door, because they thought I wanted in there to
sleep. But they were in different rooms?
Yeah, they're right next to each other. Right?
Oh, I see.
And then, Robert went in and stabbed him, and they went in and, stabbed Christopher. That's when I stabbed Christopher.
So when he stabbed Daniel, where did he stab Daniel?
I think he, shanked him in the neck, and then Daniel ran off, and so I went in and started attacking Christopher.
So Daniel got stabbed in the neck and ran off?
Yeah.
Where did he run to?
He ran into the family room about mom. Mom ended up, she was laying on the ground yelling, call 911.
Okay. And he stopped in there?
Yeah, he collapsed in there, and then Margo came in and started stabbing him in the chest.
Oh, I see.
And then
who's the youngest, the four-year-old?
The four-year-old, I don't know what happened with her. I hope she's alive, right?
I'm sorry, I messed up. The one that you stabbed, who was that?
Christopher,
that's what I'm trying to say.
He's 8 years old, I think.
He's 8.
10.
And he was in the bathroom.
Yep.
So Daniel had got stabbed in the neck, ran out to where your mom was.
Yeah.
Robert followed him, stabbed him some more.
Yep, after we stabbed Christopher in the bathroom.
Oh, I see, okay.
And then basically after that, the funeral was pretty much dead. We forgot about all.
Who was dead?
Everyone, I think.
Okay.
Looked like they were dead, except for she was lying in the interview screening. And that was a knock at the door.
Okay.
Someone knocked at the door. I think that might be the neighbor, because the police wouldn't have been there yet. And then they just kept knocking on the door. So we turned around, I grabbed on, put my soft vest and heavy vest on. I was carrying the plates, I put my helmet on. And then we went up the back door of Dan's office. Climbed over the fence, went down into the park, and started cutting through the woods.
Okay.
We both collapsed. And so we were just sitting there, and they found us.
That's how you got kind of dirty and stuff, dirt on you. So you guys collapsed. Were you just kind of hiding out?
Yeah, we were just laying in a little ditch thing in the woods, and then we saw the light, and we laid down, and the dog came over.
The dog. Did you hear the dog coming?
Mm-hmm. I heard them coming, I saw them coming, and then they started yelling, and put your hands up, mm-hmm. And then I stepped on my head and handcuffed me.
Okay.
Can you kind of, okay, I'm a little bit lost, I think because there's too many people in this house. There's you, there's Robert.
Yeah.
Okay, you're 16, he's 18. Then who's next?
Yeah, she's the third oldest. She was the first one.
Okay. And then Daniel?
And then Christopher.
Then Christopher.
And then Victoria.
Victoria. Then she's 4.
Yeah, Victoria's 4.
Okay, and what's mom's name?
April.
April?
April, that woman, unmarried maiden name, if you call it, is Sharp.
Sharp?
Yeah.
Okay, and Victoria's 4.
Mm-hmm.
And then what's Dad's name?
David.
David?
Okay. David, yes.
And then, are there any other kids? How many kids is that? That's...
And there's... I mean, she's a baby, she's about to turn 2 toddler. She was up in her bed.
Okay.
I think he forgot about her. And I think she stayed asleep until the police came.
Okay.
I saw them. Gave her out, so she's okay.
Was,
So you saw them carrying her out?
Yeah, I was in the car.
Was that the plan, was to kill her too, though?
We just want to kill everyone.
Okay.
Yeah.
So when y'all got done at the house, where were you gonna go?
We were gonna hang out there for at least the day. We were going to get, like, to get the bodies in a room or something in the attic. Clean up and then wait for the ammunition, go pick up the guns, and then we'll leave the next day.
Where were you gonna go? I mean, where was your gonna be your mass plan to get the most bang for your buck?
We're just heading generally towards Washington State. We're going to do it statewide.
Did you guys have like where you gonna go? I mean, who else were you gonna kill? Just whoever you ran into?
Yeah. Pretty much, he said 5 at a time, like gas stations, restaurants.
Okay.
And then just keep going.
Yep. Did, Did he have some money saved up or something?
Yeah, about 480 after buying all the ongoing weapons. Plus
he still had that?
Yeah, plus 100 that I had.
Oh, okay. So we talked a lot about your plans in the beginning, because here's what I don't understand is, as you and Robert are kind of planning things out, I mean, because you seem like a really smart kid, and that you kind of, I mean, it seems like you had some pretty detailed plans. You guys had good equipment and weapons. And it seems to me, and tell me if I'm wrong, but I would think that as you guys plan this out, you had maybe more specific plans, like Robert was going to kill this person, you were going to kill. So who were you supposed to kill?
I was supposed to take my pistol crossbow. Who was supposed to shank his son? She was supposed to die quietly. She was going to be the first one she was. And then Robert would go in, slit mom's throat, push her up with him, and both go in and kill Victoria.
Because it was supposed to be like quiet, right?
Yeah, it was supposed to be like that. And then I would go upstairs and shoot David, Dad, and the guy with my pistol crossbow, would kill him, and then Robert would go over and kill
him. Okay.
So did you use your crossbow at all?
No. The only time I ever hurt anybody was when I stabbed Christopher in the neck.
Did Robert use your crossbow?
No, it's just me the whole time.
Where is your crossbow?
I think it's on my bed still, unless they collected it.
So did you have it up ready to go, and then it just kind of didn't go as planned?
Yeah, no, nothing as planned.
Yeah. I think we talked about it, but did Robert, you said he had a knife that was just like yours, but it was red.
Yeah.
Did he ever use another knife on anybody else or anything?
I don't think he did. I mean, he had another small surgical blade knife. It's not like 4 inches. He said he was going to use it, but...
Where was that?
In his pocket. He had 3 knives. A large, about 15-inch black one.
Like a machete kind of thing?
Yeah, kind of like a K-bar knife.
Okay.
And the 12...
Where was that, the big one?
It was standing on his belt.
Okay.
And the one he used, the dark red one. And then the small surgical blade.
Okay. So, who all died? Who do you know died for sure? Like, what's the count? How do we know?
I don't know.
Okay.
Who do you think died?
Dad, mom, Daniel. That's about all I know, because I saw them.
And Daniel's the one that used Dad?
No, Chris was one of my stepdad. Daniel's the one he went in and stabbed him in the lungs.
And he was in the living room?
In the living room with mom.
And Christopher, you stabbed him in the neck?
Yeah, he was in the bath,
So how did, was he still making noise when you left, or how did that go down?
Yeah, he was still yelling when I left. I don't think we probably killed him. I think he might have been alive, because later I came back and the door was shot and locked it, so I had to kick it down.
Okay.
Just going, I know school was in that door.
So,
you kicked it down?
I didn't kick it down.
Okay. Who did?
I just got it too. Nobody kicked it down.
Oh.
It stayed intact. I don't know what to know if he's still alive.
Did you, because here's what I'm seeing happen. You guys had all these detailed plans. You had all the cool stuff to make it happen.
Yeah.
And it kind of started falling apart. And you said, it didn't go as planned. Did you kind of just freak out a little bit?
Is
this really happening?
I didn't know it was going to be like.
Yeah, you don't. But here's what's getting me is it's crazy because you guys worked together and made all these plans and had it all figured out, and then when it happens, you're just kind of standing there not doing anything. And did you decide Robert's gonna kill everybody and I'm gonna stand here and do nothing, so I better
I think that was my plan. I didn't want to kill anyone. I couldn't do it. So I was going to let him, kill everyone.
Yeah, but you stabbed somebody in the neck.
I just kind of...
Well, what I'm saying is it's not Robert's the one that should get all the credit here. Because it's a big deal. You're going to be on the news. You know what I mean?
I know.
People are going to want to interview you.
I don't want to be interviewed with this.
Well, but I'm just thinking
he does.
Because you had said you had the plans, like, you're supposed to kill this person.
Yep.
He's supposed to kill this person. Were you supposed to kill Christopher? Was he your responsibility?
No.
It just worked out that way?
Daniel was supposed to be his responsibility. I was always supposed to kill Dad.
But he had already basically done that.
Yeah.
So now you're left standing there. So were you trying to kill Christopher when you stabbed him in the neck? Were you just going to...
I purposely missed the middle of the neck. I think I might have even hit him in the shoulder. I certainly didn't do it hard, but...
So, originally, your responsibility was
Victoria.
And Dad.
Yep, that's who I was supposed to take care of.
Did you guys talk specific? Because you said the crossbow. So you said, I mean, you guys had it planned. Like, this is specifically how we're going to do it.
Yeah, it was specific, unfortunately. You know, I think he got his plan to move or something. It doesn't work out that way.
Yeah. Well, it was supposed to be a lot quicker and quieter, I guess. I mean, did you, so had your cell phone, is that right?
Daniel had my cell phone. They got my cell phone and called the police.
So when did you last have your cell phone that you remember?
Yeah, I remember, I think it was in my pocket, like either that or was sitting on the living room couch.
Okay.
And I don't know when he got it.
So you had maybe left it on the living room couch and gone to your room, and yeah. You guys are waiting for things to go down.
Okay, buddy.
Did he, like, ever use your phone or play with it or do any of that stuff?
No, he wasn't allowed to.
So did he only get your phone because he was trying to call for help?
Yep.
So do you think he went to the living room and got it?
Yeah, I think he did because mom was laying in the living room, you know, screaming, call the police.
And so somehow he came down the hall?
Yeah. I don't know if he might have been in my room when I was outside. I was doing nothing alone.
Okay.
I don't know what that was.
Do you know what alarm company your alarm's for?
We never actually, it's just the alarm, mm-hmm. The sound itself.
Just the sign.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's just the sign. I think it's ADT, whatever.
And are there cameras or anything in your house?
Yeah.
Where do those record to?
Hallways, living rooms, another hallway, and, it's clear.
Is it go to a computer or something somewhere?
I don't think it was being recorded, no.
Oh.
Just live.
Do you not have... Oh, so is there a TV where you can watch it somewhere?
Yeah, my dad watches it on his phone. He has an app.
Is that through, like, the cable company or something?
No, I think it's something he set up, like his own server or something.
Oh, okay. And you don't think it's being recorded?
I don't know if it was being recorded. I mean, his computer system, like, you know... super hard to get into.
Oh, but is it like a good computer system?
It's a good computer system.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, he's like a database engineer or something. So.
Oh, that's right. So as all this was going on, what was Robert saying? Did he say anything to you?
He didn't say anything to me until that we were getting ready to head out the back door. I asked him if he was okay, what was going on. He said, yeah.
Okay. So you guys were just kind of silent the whole time?
Yeah, it was silent.
Did you cut your finger? Is that your other hand? Is that...
I think I might have done this. I was just going to stab Christopher.
Okay.
So
that might be from your own knife, is what you think?
Yeah, it's my knife.
Are you right or left-handed?
I'm right-handed.
Right-handed. And so how do you think you cut your finger?
I was gentle.
Oh, you, yeah, were you holding?
No, he was on the floor, but... I might skip or something.
You don't remember?
I cut it with my own knife, I know that.
And it was, do you think it was during the time when you were stabbing him?
Yeah, I got that time.
Did you say anything to Christopher?
I just,
no. So you stabbed him, now it's several hours later. How are you feeling?
This whole thing, like film when you first there. To get caught, I think you only lasted about 30 minutes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that was like, because it's 8 o'clock in the morning now. So it's like 8 hours ago.
Yeah.
So how do you feel now? I mean, just kind of...
I didn't want to do that.
Yeah.
I shouldn't have done that.
So you were saying you pleaded with, I guess, when they were locked in the bathroom and what other room were they locked in?
The bathroom, and they were right next to it is my dad's office. Daniel locked himself in his office.
Is it just one door to get into the bathroom and the office?
No, they were right, two doors next to each other.
Right, like this?
Like, you know, like this.
In the corner?
Yeah, kind of. And I was like, I said, hello, Robert's after to me, and they both opened up.
And which room did you go in?
I went into the bathroom, just near my dad's, Christopher.
Okay. But, and then what did Robert go?
Robert went in to the office where Daniel was stabbed, and Daniel ran off, and he came into the bathroom and started stabbing Christopher. I left.
Okay.
So, I guess where I'm kind of confused is if you didn't want this anymore and you didn't want this to go down this way, why con them into opening the doors and letting this continue?
I was trying to help Robert.
And so when you guys ran out the back door with all your stuff, and of course that wasn't part of the plan, did you guys talk and like, hey, we need to go this way, and now it's high?
I think we pretty much knew where to go.
Okay.
I just kept asking if he was okay, because, you know, he acted like he was about to, you know, collapse.
Okay. Because you guys have been through those woods before?
Yeah, we used to play in them.
Okay.
I think we had to go.
And you said someone had knocked at the door.
Yeah, that's why we didn't go through the front door and get in the vehicle.
Okay.
Because someone was at the door.
And you said maybe that was the neighbor.
I think it is a neighbor. Yeah.
But did you also think, is it the police?
I know if it was the police, they would have gotten into the door because was lying right there.
Okay.
In the view of the window screening.
What was, when did you realize the police were there?
When we were in the woods.
Okay. And how did you know?
We heard the sirens, and we stayed a couple minutes later, we saw the lights.
And then you heard a dog?
Yeah.
Was a dog barking or growling or something?
It was growling.
Yeah.
Hold me up.
Okay. So at the point when you heard the sirens and stuff, were you guys kind of hiding and hunkered
down?
Yeah,
we had been sitting down.
Hoping they wouldn't behind you?
Yeah.
Okay.